The SMS desktop software includes three interpolation settings to help ensure that your data is being interpolated as accurately as possible. In this tutorial, you will learn about the three interpolation options available, benefits of each, and how to set defaults to be used across operations or projects. First, let's begin with the definition of interpolation and when it's used in SMS. Interpolation is simply a statistical method that is used to fill or average data across areas where no data is available, based on the data points that surround the gap. For example, when working with a soil sampling map, where a point only exists every 2.5 acres, to fill those areas around the site, SMS uses interpolation. Interpolation is used any time you view a grid or a contour style map that was created from point data, and also any time an analysis is performed, whether that be query results in SMS Basic or any of the analysis functions in SMS Advanced. Depending on the type of data you are working with, the type of interpolation best suited for the job can differ, which is why SMS includes two models of interpolation: inverse distance weighting and kriging. So how do you decide which interpolation method to use? Generally, inverse distance weighting is better suited for dense data sets that contain many GPS points, such as yield or as-applied data. In this interpolation method, you get to define the maximum distance and distance ratio. The maximum distance tells the software what distance from the known data point to search for other data points to include when averaging. The distance ratio will determine the weight or influence each of the included data points will have when averaging the information. Adjusting the distance ratio allows you to control the amount of smoothing that will occur within the data set. While inverse distance weighting is good for dense data sets, it does not perform well for very sparse data sets, such as soil sampling results. For these types of data sets, where the GPS points are few and typically further distance from each other, kriging is the preferred method. Kriging tends to provide a better approximation of the values that fall between the known data points, leaving you with a more accurate map. When using kriging, you can define the maximum number of points, maximum search distance, variogram type, scale, and nugget effect. As you can see, kriging requires you to define far more parameters than inverse distance weighting, which can also lead to increased processing time if used on dense data sets. The type of interpolation and parameters for each are totally up to you. You can even define operational defaults if you want to use interpolation methods for different operations. But what if you don't want to have to remember what statistical method should be used for your yield maps versus your fertility data? In cases where you simply want SMS to use the right method based on the data you're working with, without you having to modify any settings, you have the option to have SMS automatically set the gridding and interpolation values for you. If you choose to auto-set gridding and interpolation methods, available under the General Options, Grid Options tab, SMS will identify what style of interpolation should be used based on the data set you're working with, meaning you don't have to modify any settings based on the operation you're currently working with. With this method selected, SMS will still use either inverse distance weighting or kriging, but the selected option will vary based on what information is available in the data set you're working with. You will also need to go to Services and Map Settings Utility and click the Set All Items to Use Automatic Grid Interpolation Settings button. Clicking this button will tell SMS to always use the automatic settings when gridding, contouring, or generating analysis results, so be aware that any previously saved interpolation settings will be overwritten. Have a very dense data set that includes a swath width? Then SMS will use inverse distance weighting. This means when you contour your harvest maps to help identify yield zones, inverse distance weighting will be used to average the data together. The grid size used will be either half the swath width of the implement used to record data, but will max out at 30 feet and never be smaller than 10 feet. The maximum distance setting will be 1.5 times the swath width. Working with soil fertility results spaced a wide distance apart with no swath width, SMS will use creaking interpolation and will use all points in the linear variogram setting. The grid sizes used with creaking will always be 30 by 30 feet. These settings allow you to average and smooth these very sparse data sets across the entire field for analysis and for use when building recommendations. So what happens if you don't choose to use the automatic grid and interpolation settings, but don't remember to modify the default settings for all of your operations? In this case, SMS will first check to see if you have previously saved any operational defaults, and if so, we'll use those settings. If no operational defaults have been saved in your copy of SMS, then the software will use the default settings of SMS, which may or may not be suitable for each of the operations you work with, so be sure to review the results after the first few fields. You've now learned about the different interpolation models available in SMS, when to use each, and how using the automatic gridding and interpolation settings can save you time while still using your data accurately. For more information about any of the features of SMS, please review the other tutorials.